Welcome to Open for Business, the Gallatin Valley's only local business and consumer talk show featuring Tom Eaglehoff, the Man Entrepreneur magazine radio called the leading authority in the United States for doing business in small town. Here he is, speaker, author, small business consultant, and Mrs. Eaglehoff's favorite son, Tom Eaglehoff.
All right. Welcome, everyone. Open for Business. We air every Saturday live from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Mountain Time on AM 1450 KMMS in Bozeman, 1340 KPRK in Livingston, Montana. If you'd like to be a part of the big broadcast, go to KMMSAM.com and click Listen Live. The call-in number during the show, 406-522-TALK, 406-522-8255. I'm here. You're here. Let's get the show on the road. All right, welcome back, everyone. It is 24 minutes before the top of the hour. It is Saturday, January 6, 2018, 40 degrees outside. I want to welcome you to the podcast portion of Open for Business. Each week, I share some tips and tricks I've learned over the years about advertising, marketing, promotion, and building strong, successful businesses. And if you missed any of my previous podcasts, you'll find them all on my YouTube channel. And while you're here, why not subscribe to my YouTube channel? And you'll never miss another weekly podcast. You'll also find a link to my podcast on my website that 3,000 people visit each and every day at smalltownmarketing.com. That's smalltownmarketing.com. In today's topic, I want to talk about how to use fundamentals to build a strong business. Well, thanks to basketball, I was able to attend college on an athletic scholarship. My parents might have been able to send me, and probably would have, but I was grateful they didn't have to. And I also had the pleasure of playing on a team that achieved some success. In fact, the team I played on was inducted into the College Hall of Fame a few years ago. And the reason we were successful against some very good opponents was due to two things: teamwork and fundamentals. And these same two items are the principal reasons why one small business will succeed and another will fail. So in this podcast, I want to explain to you how you can use both to make your business more successful in 2018. You need to create both objectives and strategies in your business. So before playing another team, we would examine the strengths and weaknesses of that team. Then we'd assemble some objectives that we felt would lead to victory if we executed them properly. For example, as an objective, we'd want to neutralize the opposing team's best player as much as possible. One strategy to make that happen might be to assign our best defensive player to their best offensive player. But even the best defensive player will sometimes need help, and that's where the teamwork comes in. While at the same time, a good defense comes from hours and hours of practice, strength training, determination to be the best possible players we can. These same tactics apply to business. So here are some ways we can apply these same basic principles to your business. Let's say our objective is to increase sales by 10% in the first quarter of 2018. What are some strategies we can use to make that happen? Well, one objective is, can you attract more customers? The strategies we might use is to analyze your current customer base. Who's your ideal customer? What characteristics do they have in common? Age, income, education, etc. And who are similar customers you might be missing? Have you added any new products or service that would be of value to a different customer? Can you create a brand new customer? A child's turned 16, he or she is now a driver. They're now a tire customer, mechanics customer, insurance customer, car wash customer, gas station customer. People getting engaged will need to eventually combine two households. So is there an opportunity there for people who are getting married? Another objective, can you increase your average sale? If your average sale is $100, how will you increase that to $110? Well, train your salespeople to show value and not rely on price as your selling point. Look through your sales each day. Are any of your employees missing an opportunity to sell the customer a better product or service? You need salespeople, not order takers. Customers buy benefits, not features. Salespeople need to know how to find customers' needs and connect those customer needs to the benefits of the product. The more benefits a product has to the customer, the less important price becomes, and the happier the customer will be in the long run. Another objective might be add-on sales. Increase profits with add-on sales. Teach your salespeople to package products together. You never sell a man's dress shirt without a matching tie. Every cell phone order should have a car charger and a protective case. These extra usually have a higher profit margin that will add to your bottom line, and they increase the value of the product to the customer. Another objective is always sell your five most profitable products and services. Make sure all salespeople know your most profitable products and services and how to sell them. You're shortchanging your customers by not presenting them with the best option for their needs. So have salespeople practice on each other for better product presentations. The point to take away from today's podcast is for you to sit down and define what you need to do to keep the doors open in 2018. How many sales per day, per week, per month will it take for the business to remain profitable? There are going to be a host of problems, which you'll have absolutely no control over. Gas prices, corporate layoffs, unemployment rates, housing market, taxes, credit market, to name just a few. However, with a detailed plan of what you want to accomplish, you'll at least have a fighting chance at achieving the success you want. Now, if you could add just a few cents per sale, where would you be in 2019? And that's the podcast. If you missed any of my previous podcasts, you'll find them all on my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. You'll also find a link to my podcast on my website that 3,000 people visit each and every day at smalltownmarketing.com. That's smalltownmarketing.com. So tune in each Saturday, and let's build successful businesses together.